Tia Annie told me, you could never be a writer, let alone a poet. What do you know? I mean, what can you write about? You got a D on your last book report. You gotta be able to write English good, use big words, and you've never even been out of Oxnard. Writers travel all the time. New York, Paris, Rome, every place they make oil of Olay, that's where writers go. That's where they live. Your family doesn't have money to travel. You never will. And you don't even type. Now, how are you gonna be a writer? Sure, some famous poets, they say, wrote longhand, but that was long ago, and they were men. Men have it so easy, worthless, lazy dogs, but you want to know about that. Because you've never been with one. You've never ate, slept, inhaled pure, passionate love. Writers are always in love, like this Harlequin romance I'm reading. Now, how are you gonna be a writer? You don't even like boys yet. You've never given your heart to a boy so he could take it, hold it, clench it, wring it dry to toss away, forgotten in the gutter. They make you cry, hurt, suffer. Writers know stuff like that. They heal their pain with words. You don't know about pain, anguish, outrage, protest. Look on TV. The Brown Berets, they're marching. The whole Chicano movement passing you by, and you don't even know about that. You weren't born in no barrio, no torteria down your street. Bullets never whiz past your baby head. Chicana without a cause. No, mija. Nobody will ever buy your books. So put your pencil down and change the channel for me. It's time for As the World Turns. And my response is entitled Eos Dicen. My grandmother told me,
no te gusta limpiar, nunca cuidas a tus primas, ni sabes cómo cocinar. Cuando te casas y salgas de la casa, ¿qué vas a hacer?
The complaints about my life choices don't stop there.
My Nina told me, ay, Yelly, you and your feminist stuff. You're always studying with a book in your hand, but do you even know how to wash dishes?
I'm just playing with you, but don't you want a boyfriend someday? And so begins my roar of laughter that cowers in the face of a culture who only knows the love of patriarchy. And I know this culture is filled with so much more because as I say this, you can't help but remember watching Drunken Nights backed by Vicente's voice. Y quieres volver, volver, volver a esta noche. But are you going to stop me before flashbacks of your father begin to play in your head? The ones from that same night where he is telling your little brother, que los hombres no lloran. Since that night, your baby brother stopped coming into your room in the dead of night to tell you of the scary figures that say hello in his dreams. You don't remember the last time a tear escaped his cold stare because he doesn't know tears anymore. All he knows is that his father bought him a pair of pants he could only wear so long as he puffed out his chest and forgot what it was to feel. You start to remember when your grandmother taught you and your primas how to make tortillas hecho a mano. You remember the arguments and the screams of your primos as grass stained the knees of their pants as they wrestled in the front yard. Conversations centering around my path towards marriage, towards motherhood, away from myself, all seemed to leave a stale taste from responses locked between teeth and tongue, never once feeling the air encompassed by attention only felt through machismo. Las mujeres de mi cultura have always had to prove their worth through the masa that permanently sticks to the palms of their hands. Through the strands of sweat-stained foreheads that stay plastered onto their foreheads, through the heart-piercing screams that push through the tiny lungs of the children they push past their dreams.
No puedes tenerlo todo. Ellos te dicen, y te dicen, y te dicen lo que puedes y no puedes hacer.
My only response, me vale. See, I've always been the selfish one. Always serving myself food before anyone else because the only noise I listen to beckons me from the pit of my torso. I may not wear a brown beret, but I fight with my fists held high because this Chicana has a cause that isn't waiting for someone to fight in my place. There is a revolution on its way, and there is no time to shove our women into corners of, si, mi amor, eres el más macho. The same woman who 700 years ago were considered warriors for breathing into new life. A woman's place has never been in the kitchen, but in the revolution. Pero like, si quieres, haz los dos cosas. Do you, mami, te estoy apoyando. Así que, por favor, dime dónde debería estar mi futuro. I'm not holding back.